Hi guys, Matthew with Parkway Business Solutions, bringing you a new review of MoneyThumb and their financial file conversion software that gives you the ability to convert CSV files into QBO files or PDF files, especially into QBO files. They even have a specialized one, which we're going to cover today, the 2QBO Convert Pro Plus, which will give you the ability to take paper PDF statements, scan them in, and it will run its own OCR software on the files and be able to extract the information. So give us a quick second here and join us for a quick review again of MoneyThumb's 2QBO Convert Pro Plus. Anybody who's watched any of our YouTube channels in the past was probably able to figure out pretty quickly that I'm not a big fan of manual data entry, which is what led me to start finding easier ways to get the information into accounting softwares like QuickBooks or Zero, so forth. This software has by far done a better job than any of the other ones on the market that we've played with. Real quickly, I'm going to do a demonstration of how it works. So I'm going to go through, and my first step, you can go one of two ways. I always go straight into the settings, of course, and I'm going to establish a couple details that are important. So, you know, whether it's a bank versus a credit card, this one happens to be a bank. The bank, the financial institution, is one of the most common challenges that we come across with QBO files, and it's really easy to fix. I love the fact they've got this built-in search capability to find your bank. So for this one, we can type in the bank information and click OK. It's going to automatically populate with the appropriate Intuit bank ID number that's necessary for it to pull in. You then have the ability, if you'd like, to add the routing number, as well as you can add an account number. Neither of these are necessary, so if you're concerned for safety or security, it's not required, but it does make matching a lot easier to the import process, especially like with QuickBooks Desktop. It will help to automatically match which account it should be going into. For this round, I'm not going to play with any of the advanced features. We're just going to very quickly come in. If we click OK at this point, now I'm going to come up to my Convert, and I'm going to choose the appropriate file that I want to use. When you get to the import screen, you're going to find that there's quite a few different formats that can be utilized to get the information into the system. So, of course, you have your PDF that you can do. You have CSV, so basically different Excel formats, but you can also use this to convert other types of QBO, QIF files, OFX files, so forth. So if you have Quicken files, if your bank will only allow you to download those, you could pull a Quicken file in, convert it to a QBO that could then be used for QuickBooks Desktop or QuickBooks Online. For this example, we'll continue forward with the PDF. Having selected the statement, we're going to go through and do a preview of the information so we can see what it's going to look like first, which is something I recommend for everybody that's just getting used to the program. After you've done it a couple times, you can do a more express version just by clicking the convert to a CSV or convert to a QBO. So I clicked the preview, you saw how fast it went through, and this is now gone through and cleaned up all the details of the dates. The payee, I did not do anything special with the cleanup settings at this time, but I can if I want to. If I had, you know, prepayment for different language like that at the front, you could have that removed. The amounts that are inside of here, and of course you have the ability to switch your signs positive and negative. What's really, really neat about this program, it also reconciles the information for you. So the whole log back here basically went through and it's showing you a map of all the details that it saw. But if you look at the special font here, you're going to see it says reconciled as a bank statement. It's going to show you the number of transactions for credits and debits. And when I pull that statement back up again, we will be able to check the amounts in comparison. So we've got our total credits here for 7375.38. We have our debits for 5689.29. At the top here, most of the time it will actually catch the starting balance for you as well. If it does not, it gives you the ability to put this in. The reason this is important is when you have the beginning and the ending balance, when that file is imported into the system, it will set the ending balance as what the bank says the ending balance is. So picture you've got a whole bunch of smaller clients that don't really need to be connected consistently for bank feeds. What you could do is download all of the statements or the CSV files, pull them through this software to be able to clean them up, especially with the payee information. Get it all cleaned up and then create a single import file of all of that information. So now that we've gone through and we've looked very, very quickly at the information, we feel that it's good to push it in. I'm going to go through and I'm just going to click Create QBO. It's now created the file for me. If I open up my QuickBooks desktop for this example, I can come up to my banking, bank feeds, import a Web Connect file, and now we'll go pull up that specific file. You'll notice here that the financial institution information is showing up appropriately at the top, thanks to the information you put into MoneyThumb's program. You can choose to either import into an existing account, or if you haven't had one created, you could do so at the same time. So since this is all new, we'll do the My Bank, click Continue. Your Web Connect has been successfully pulled right into the system. Now that you have all of the transactions into QuickBooks Desktop, you should be able to take advantage of your banking rules to help capture a lot of the transactions as they're being pulled in. If you're not familiar with the banking rules, check out one of our other videos on our channel, and it goes through a more detailed explanation of how to manipulate the rules to capture more of the information and ultimately reduce your data entry. In our upcoming video, we're going to go a little bit further with MoneyThumb to show you how you can utilize their payee cleanup feature to really hone in on what information is coming through on the memo and the payee, which again will help improve those rules and ultimately reduce the amount of data entry that you have to do on a monthly basis. If you've got additional questions or looking for some advice, feel free to leave a comment below or reach out to us directly at info@parkwaymail.com. And as always, here's wishing you a very successful week.